Namaskar to one and all. Myself Dr. Ashokan, Professor and Head, Department of PG Studies in Prasuti Tantra and Stri Roga, Paral Institute of Ayurveda, Paral University, Vadodara, Gujarat. I would like to share with you the topic of Standard Operative Procedures for Univarti and Case Study on Univarti in Pre-Malignant Lesions of the Cervix. Welcome. Coming to the introduction, Univarti is one among the Sthanika Chikitsa. It has been indicated as the first line of treatment in the context of Shleshmala Yonivapada. To define the Univarti, Vartis are therapeutic agents which are elongated, having tapering ends, thick and broad at the center and thin and tapering at both the ends, which are used for external use, that is the Sthanika Chikitsa in Stri Roga. It is one among the Shashti Rupakrama of Vrana Chikitsa and comes under the Varti Kalpana. Commonly used to expel the accumulated stool, urine, pus, blood and Shleshma named as Palavarti, which incorporates Budavarti or Yonivarti. Thus it expels the Sanchita Dosha and also controls the local infections. The method of preparation includes: the required fine powder of the drugs are mixed with the adhesive agents like masha, dugdha and rolled into a wick form. The vartis are prepared and kept for drying in the shade. The size of the varti to be rolled into the thickness of pradeshini anguli, that is that of the index finger, according to the need of the patient, 2 to 6 angula in length. The purpose is for shodhana, vranaropana and krimighna. And the duration is until the urge for micturation, the drug should be administered for muhurdharya or kshanamdharya. That means we can administer the varti and keep it in position until the urge for micturation, that is around 2 to 3 hours in one sitting, whichever is the earliest. The site includes the external genitalia, that is the prathama avarta of the yoni. Interval is twice in a day or once in a day according to the need of the patient. We have the vartis like Pippalyadi Univarti, Trifaladi Varti, Nimba Varti, Arkadi Varti, etc. The indications for application of Univarti are Kaphaja Yonivapada, Garbhashaya Shodhana Artha, Karanini Yonivapada, Vrana in the Yoni Mukha, Acharana Yonivapada, Shweta Pradara, Yoni Shofa, Yoni Kleda, excessive or discharge per vagina, Yoni Kandu, Yoni Paichilyata, that is slimy mucoid discharge, and Anarthava, secondary absence of menstruation. The indications also include the use of Yavak Churna, Saindhava, and Arkadugda for Bhavana in Kaphaja Yonivapada, Kushta, Pippali, Arkagra, Saindhava, Bhavana with Bastamutra in case of Karanini Univapada, Gopitta and or Matsyapitta Bhavita Varti in case of Acharana Univapada, Gopitta or Matsyapitta Bhavita in case of Yoni Kandu, Shofa and Kleda. The Purva Karma for Yoni Varti Dharana include informed written consent of the patient, the part to be prepared, evacuation of the bladder prior to the procedure, positioning of the patient, that is the dorsal position with the legs flexed at knees, that is Uttana Shayana with Sankuchita Sakti, monitoring the vitals like recording of the BP, pulse, temperature of the patient, Yoni Prakshalana by Sukhoshna Jala. So these are the prerequisites. The Pradhana Karma or main operative procedure of the Univarti includes cleansing the vulva and the vagina with Sukhoshna Jala. Vaginal canal should be lubricated and the varti should be anointed with either of taila, gritha, madhu, dugdha or sukoshna jala according to the need. The prepared varti should be introduced slowly into the vagina to the posterior fornix and it should be retained and kept there until the urge for micturation. The Paschat Karma or the post-operative procedure and the care for Univarti incorporates: observe for irritation at the Sthanika region, that is the vaginal canal, if any. Monitor for 2 to 3 hours for any abnormal vaginal discharges, burning sensation, hot feeling, etc. Vaginal irrigation to drain the residual dravyas after the specific period of time using Sukoshna Jala and using a plastic syringe. And the methods for Yonivarti incorporate setting up of the required materials like a pair of sterile gloves, sterile gauze pieces, bubble for Varti, Sukoshna Jala, Cusco speculum, Sim speculum, anterior vaginal wall retractor, sponge holding forceps, disposable syringe for Prakshalana, stainless steel vessel with 500 ml capacity to up to 1 liter capacity for the Kwatha or Sukoshna Jala. As well, we can use the enema pot. The mode of action of Varti can be because of its administration through the transvaginal route, it has better bioavailability as the drugs can bypass the liver metabolism because of the rich vascular vaginal mucosa enhance the absorption of the drugs. Vartis are also hygroscopic in nature and they absorb the cervical and vaginal discharges. The quicker absorption of the absorption power with the more bioavailability of the therapeutic agents is possible through Yonivarti. The Varti show the action according to the drugs used like Shodhana, Ropana, Krimighna and Kandughna. So it is indicated in vaginal infections like trichomoniasis and moniliasis. The safety measures to be taken during Varti application include it should be prepared under aseptic precaution, reserved under aseptic precaution and used under aseptic precautions. Coming to the introduction of the case study, vulvovaginal candidiasis is second most common cause of vulvovaginitis. The indulgence in kapha prakopaka nidana including agnimandya leads to the rasadi dhatu dushti manifesting in the yoni as kaphaja yonimapath, or if it is left untreated it may manifest as karanini yonimapath with cervical erosion. The chronic cervical erosion along with other extrinsic causative factors like HPV infections and poor sexual hygiene and immunodeficiency conditions predispose the woman to early premalignant lesions like that of dysplastic changes, LSIL, HSIL or CIN. The incidence and the need for screening patients with cervical erosion include around 1 to 2 lakh of new cases with a mortality of 70 to 80,000 women per annum is reported as per WHO's reporting, whereas the cervical malignancies accounts to 15% of all types of cancers in India affecting the woman. This case study is based on the International Conference of Harmonization for good clinical practice guidelines. The chief complaints and the duration were noted as the woman who was a primiparous, aged 29 years, she came with the complaints of whitish discharge per vagina which was recurrent in nature since past 4 months associated with the complaints of vulvovaginal itching since past 4 months. We include complaints of whitish discharge per vagina since past 4 months, aggravated since 1 month. Regular menstrual cycles were observed in the menstrual history, associated with itching and thick curdy discharges in post-ovulatory phase of the cycle. The familial history revealed psychological stress in the family which was moderate in nature since past 1 month. No much relevant past history was noted either of medical or of surgical origin. Personal history revealed professionally she was a teacher. Dietary habits include regular use of abhishandi ahara like curds in the bhojana, kapha prakopaka nidana,
like abhyayama, mutraveg dharana during the working hours due to the feeling of unhygienic environment. No divasapna was elicited. She used to do brisk walking daily as a mode of exercise. No other modes of exercise were in practice. Less intake of oral fluid, or especially water, per day approximately was 1 liter per day, with a history of dysuria. Bowel were regular and non-constipated. The menstrual history revealed her LMP was on 25th 6th of 2017, which was regular in nature at an interval of 30 days with a duration of 4 to 5 days. The marital life was consanguineous. Obstetrical history was that of single parity, that is primipara, with 7 years of the age of the child, which was a full term normal delivery, and there is a history of abortion too after the first delivery. The coital history was once to twice in 30 days with itching to the male partner after the coitus. The contraceptive practices was coitus interruptus since past 7 years. The general examination revealed build was moderate, tongue was not coated, pulse rate was 72 beats per minute, which was regular and corresponded with Vata Pitta Nadi. Blood pressure was 110 bar 70 mm of Hg. Respiratory rate was 18 per minutes, which was regular. Temperature, she was afebrile. Systemic examination were within normal limits, and all the Dashaveda Parikshas were within normal limits. On examination, patient had perabdominal, soft, non-tender. The breast examination was soft and non-tender. Pulse speculum examination revealed thick, curdy, whitish discharge with quantitatively profuse, flaky in appearance. Unhealthy looking cervix with both the lips moderately eroded. Normal shape and size of the cervix was observed. Pervaginally anti-worted and normal sized uterus was elicited. The fornices were free. The treatment plan was yoni prakshalana with sukhoshna jala, followed by trifaladi yonivarti dharana per vagina 3 hours twice a day for 7 days. The pathya and apathya, ahara and vihara were advised, like intake of plenty of water, fresh leafy vegetables, and maintenance of hygiene. Avoid coitus for 7 days and also to avoid intake of excessive madhura, amla, lavana, ahara and dadhi and excessive kshira. The outcome of the study was there was a marked reduction in the srava, kandu and vedana, that is discharges, itching and pain in the vulval region. Candidiasis on wet vaginal swab was observed before the study and after the study. Pap smear also was done before the trial of the medicines and after the trial of the medicines. It revealed low-grade squamous epithelial lesions before the trial, whereas the squamous epithelial lesions were negative for inflammatory smear after the trial of a duration of 15 days. That is 7 days treatment followed by 7 days of follow-up period. The vaginal smear was positive for pseudo hyphae before the trial, whereas it was negative for the same after the trial at the end of 7th day itself. The follow-up investigations and examinations were done subsequent 3 months interval. The picture depicts how the cervix was eroded and unhealthy and unhygienic before the trial, whereas at the end of 15th day, how the cervix looked more healthy than before the trial. The probable mode of action of the drugs could be the Trifala with the Kafagna and Tridoshagna action, the Haridra with the Kandugna action, as well as the Krimigna effect, Nimba, which is Krimigna in nature, Tankana, which is Shleshmahara and Lekhana in nature, Thus, the Triphaladivarti consists of Rukshana Guna and Ushnavirya Dravya, which is absolutely indicated in Shleshmiki Yoni Vapada. The Yoni Prakshalana, that is the dowsing with Ushnajala, drained out the whitish discharge, and the Yonivarti imparted the dryness and denatured the bacterial colonies of the Candida, maintained the pH and healed the CIN1 lesion by healthy cervical re-epithelialization. Thus, to conclude, early detection screening alone can help and to adopt the preventive measure for cervical carcinoma by identifying the pre-malignant lesion with investigations like pap smear and cervical biopsy. Thus, the mortality rate of the woman due to the cervical erosion can be substantially reduced. The abnormal discharge per vagina should not be neglected, and the awareness regarding the abnormal discharge per vagina, either mucoid or blood tinged, is significant in the preventive care. Triphaladi Yonivarti acted as Shodhana, Ropana and Vyadihara due to the Krimigna action in Shleshmaja Yoni Vapada associated with this cellular pre-malignant changes. Thank you.